Hi folks, just a quick update on how to post-process each of your time-lapse pictures you took of the night sky. So I'm using Lightroom for this at the moment, and as you can see, I've opened up all of my images in Lightroom. And my problem, at least when I'm in the city, the problem is always that you have this brownish looking sky that is completely washed out by the light pollution of the city. And actually that is not so attractive, of course. So what you can do is just use your graduated filter. I don't know where it graduated from, but it's a very good tool to use. So if you just drag it on your photo and you look a little bit, the hand of the mouse button, if you go over the dot here, then you see what area of the picture is going to be affected. And in this case, we only want the sky to be affected, so it takes a little bit of hassle. And let's say it is this. And also you see that here on the top end, you see like this deep red, and closer to the middle line of the graduated filter, you can see that it's turning into white again. So what it says is it will gradually decrease the effects of the that's why it's a graduated filter. Okay. Ah, I just realized it. Oh my god, my English. So it will gradually decrease the effect of what you're doing once you get close to this middle line. Anyway, so what we wanted to do is I think two things. First of all, I don't like the color of the night sky. So what I always do is just I drag the temp slider a little bit to the left to pull out a more bluish looking sky. And of course, you can see for yourself what kind of sky you actually like. But let's go for this. And of course, we can then also look at the saturation. So if we put a little bit more saturation into it, we get this a little bit more color into it. And actually what you can then also do, a third thing, is you want to be able to see the stars. So I'm always working with clarity for that, so you can pull up the clarity a bit. If you do it too much, you get these let's go in, you get these really grainy looking, this grainy looking sky. So you have to watch out a little bit. So you can say, okay, maybe I go to 45%. So now the grain is not too bad, and you can more clearly see. So this, if you don't use it, you see the stars like this, and if you do use it, you see that the contrast gets higher basically, and you see the stars coming out. And then of course you can also think about exposure. Exposure, maybe you want to have a little bit of a darker sky. Depends a little bit on your shutter time in you used. You can work with exposure and contrast. You can basically go through all of the settings, of course. So highlights, maybe a little bit up, because you can then better see the stars. No, it does not have a lot of effect in this case. Whites. Okay. Blacks is also, you can maybe make the sky a little bit more dark by pulling black. This is in a couple of minutes we went from this to this. And what is really nice about Lightroom is that you can just copy these settings. So you can just check copy, and then if I hold down the shift button on my keyboard and I just select, for instance, these pictures, or you can just select all of your pictures for that sake, and you can just press sync and click on synchronize, and then it synchronizes the settings for all of these time-lapse pictures or maybe star trail pictures you took. So that's all I wanted to show you actually. So this is a really nice way of improving your night sky without actually also affecting the front and the other parts of your picture. I hope this information is useful to you, and see you next time. Bye bye.